Engem Rév Istvánnak hívnak, vagyok ennek az Archivumnak a vezetője, és köszönöm szépen, hogy a rossz idő ellenére is eljöttek. Fordítani fogom a saját rövid mondókámat. So good evening, my name is István Rév, I'm the director of the archive, and thank you very much for being with us this evening, despite the very bad weather. A lot of people sent messages saying that they would not be able to come because of the rain. It's becoming slowly cold and wintry in the city. Ez a kiállítás egy rokonunknak a kiállítása tulajdonképpen. A Nyílt Társadalom Alapítvány, amely Soros György hozott létre, az egy világ különböző területein, 70 országban működő alapítvány, amelynek nagyon sok tematikus programja van, és az egyik programja egy dokumentum fotográfiai program, amely hosszú ideje támogat művészeket és rendez kiállításokat, elsősorban New Yorkban. Ez az első eset, amikor egy New Yorki kiállítást áthoztunk Budapestre. So this exhibition is comes to us from New York from our sister organization, the Open Society Foundations, established by George Soros, who established the archive and also Central European University. The foundations, which is active in all over the world, in about 70 countries, has several thematic programs, among them a documentary photography initiative, which supports artists, activists who try to document important issues in the world, and at the same time the foundation regularly organizes exhibitions in the New York offices and also in the Washington offices of the foundations. And this is the first time, but not the last one, when we are collaborating with the program, and we bring here an exhibition that was already successfully organized in New York. We thought that this is an important topic, surveillance, the relationship between information gathering and privacy. We behave sometimes as if it were just the problem of the United States, but this is what we know most about, and it is really worrying that we don't know almost anything what's going on in our countries, in this part of the world, what's going on in Hungary, for example. We have very good reasons to suppose that there is pervasive surveillance going on in Hungary, but perhaps a Snowden would have a more difficult time in this country than even he has in exile in Russia, Russia today. So we thought that it would be important to call the attention of the Hungarian public to this important phenomenon, and decided not only to have an exhibition here, but also to organize a peculiar film series, an international secret police film festival, which will go on in the coming weeks in the archive. And at the very end of this program, there will be a finissage where we try to have a public discussion about these issues. Now, I would like to say that I'm not here in order to open the exhibition. We are fortunate enough that we have the original New York, or one of the original New York curators of the exhibition with us, Yukiko Yamagata, who is the associate director of the documentary photography initiative of the Open Society Foundations. She worked with the New York Public Library before, and she also worked at the Vitnes Museum of American Art in New York as well. And after her, we asked Mátyás Erdély, who is in a sense very close to all these people who are watching us, because he's in the business of watching people. He's a cinematographer and a very successful one. As some of you might know, this spring the film he made as a cinematographer won the Grand Prix of the Cannes Film Festival, and a few weeks ago at another film festival he was selected as the best cinematographer in Europe at the moment. Then he will say a few words, and then at the end we would like to invite you for a small reception about us. Tehát azt mondtam még el angolul, hogy azt gondoltuk, hogy ez egy fontos kérdés, amiről Magyarországon keveset szoktunk beszélni, és úgy teszünk, mintha a megfigyelés az kizárólag az Egyesült Államok sötét tevékenységének lenne a következménye. És miközben egyre többet tudunk, még mindig nagyon keveset, arról, hogy mi történik ottan a sötétben, amikor bennünket megfigyelnek. Arról, hogy mi történik Magyarországon ezen a téren, semmit sem tudunk, és nem is szoktunk erről beszélni, sőt gondolkodni is nagyon keveset. Pedig tudjuk, hogy ez történik. Néhány héttel ezelőtt egy európai, magyar európai parlament képviselő egy közleményt tett közé, amiben azt írta, hogy egy magyar jogvédővel beszélt telefonon, amikor megszakadt a vonal, és visszahallotta a beszélgetés teljes szövegét a telefonban. Az a magyar jogvédő, akivel beszélt, az én fiam volt véletlenül. Úgyhogy ez csak nem csupán csak egy absztrakt kérdés, hogy bennünket megfigyelnek. Szerencsés helyzetben vagyunk, mert itt van a kiállítás amerikai egyik kurátor is velünk, aki néhány szót fog szólni mindarról, amit látható, és utána pedig Erdély Mátyás filmoperatőrt kértük meg. Azt gondoltuk, hogy jobb, hogy egy szakmabelit kérünk fel, nem pedig egy jogvédőt, hanem egy olyan embert, akinek azzal telik az élete, hogy a kamera mögül figyel, mondja el azt, hogy ő arról az oldalról miképpen látja ezt a kérdést, és aztán várjuk önöket ott az első emeleten egy kis fogadásra. Köszönöm még egyszer, hogy eljöttek.
Good evening. Thank you, István. We are particularly excited to have this exhibit here at the Open Society Archives, given the themes and the content of this exhibition has such synergy with the archives' mission and collection. And as István mentioned, the show is organized by the Open Society Documentary Photography Project. We have been organizing a series called Moving Walls since 1998, and we have featured over 200 photographers in our New York gallery space. And what makes our space really unique, and this exhibition series really unique, is that we're not just interested in the history and aesthetics of photography and documentary photography, but really interested in the role that photography plays in advancing human rights and social justice issues, and highlighting the ways in which the creative process can perhaps reveal something that perhaps is not seen by the human rights workers and the advocates that we normally work with. So it really plays a special role within the foundation as well as within other exhibition spaces in New York. And we're really exploring questions of, you know, how photography can help us see these issues differently. And so Watching You, Watching Me, which is the exhibit on Pew, is our 22nd exhibition. And one of their primary goals was to address the question of why surveillance matters. What are the real world consequences in terms of privacy and basic rights? And this tension that is often presented to us between privacy and security, both personal individual security on the community level as well as the national level. And you know, in a context in which we've become so accustomed to our information and our activities being shared and documented, this sense of privacy is rapidly eroding. So when you speak to people of different generations, you really get a sense of the ways in which we really perceive our own privacy very differently. And often what you hear is, you know, if I'm not doing anything wrong, then I have nothing to worry about, and so it's fine that my actions are being monitored. And so we really wanted to address that and also address this challenge of what does surveillance actually look like? Who is doing it and how does it work? And how are artists confronting the challenge of documenting and visualize something that is inherently meant to be hidden? It's both omnipresent and masked at the same time. So in curating the show, we posed this question to photographers. We put out a call for work, and we received over 400 proposals. And so the 10 artists that you see here today are selected from those 400. And they really use a range of approaches from more traditional documentary photography. Edu Bayer from Spain is coming much more from a photojournalistic background. And then we have works that are much more conceptual in nature, more in the realm of contemporary art. We also have artists that are mining archives in some way. And then we also have people who are using photography and intervening in the public space and creating street art as well. So all of them in some way are revealing who is doing the watching. They're addressing those in power and saying, we are watching you, watch us, hence the title. And so we have examples of people who are exploring really the physical remnants of state-run surveillance operations. For example, work from the archives of the East German Stasi, as well as images from Gaddafi's internet surveillance headquarters. We also have an artist who's looking at documents that prove that the New York City Police Department was heavily monitoring the activities of and the businesses that were owned by Muslims post September 11th. And not only were they looking at religious institutions as the businesses owned, but also internet cafes and sports centers. So very kind of what seemingly mundane locations that were being tracked by these undercover officers. We're also looking at the role of technology and the border surveillance system, for example, that monitors Europe's external borders, as well as the corporations that are developing and profiting from surveillance technologies. The show also really addresses how surveillance has become a part of our daily lives and normalized in many ways, whether it's through CCTV or Google Street View or Google Earth, as well as the use of drones that is becoming more and more commonplace, especially in the United States. And what was interesting was that, you know, overall, a lot of these images are actually quite mundane, although the images are collected as a form of intelligence gathering. The images don't, in and of themselves, don't really tell us very much. Rather, it's the context and the people and the governments and the corporations that are storing, interpreting, sharing, and analyzing this data and putting it to use that is so problematic. A lot of this exhibition also addresses issues of scale and just the sheer mass of imagery and information that's being collected. So you'll see that a number of the installations are very dense, and they're meant to be intentionally overwhelming. So I encourage you to really spend time and take and read all the text and really look at the details of some of these installations. And the show, you know, I would say doesn't really intend to provide answers, but really attempts to prompt some questions. So I hope you spend some time with the work and walk away with a better sense of what those questions are and what they mean for you. And before closing, I just wanted to thank our colleagues at the Open Society Archives. It's really been a pleasure to work with you. The exhibit and the complimentary programming, I think, will very much enrich your experience of the artwork itself. So thank you, and I hope you enjoy your evening.
Én hány nyelven, csak nagyon gyorsan összefoglalnám a néhány lényeges pontját ennek a megnyitó beszédnek. Ez a kiállítás a 22. kiállítás. Egy felhívást tettek közzé, ötleteket várva a művészektől, 400 művész jelentkezett, közülük 10-et választottak ki, akiknek a művei ezen a kiállításon szerepelnek. A dokumentum fotográfiai programnak az a célja, hogy ne csupán művészi, esztétikai szempontból mutassa meg a fotográfus szemével a körülöttünk lévő világot, hanem a fotográfus segítségül hívva olyan fontos jelenségekre tudjon rávilágítani, amelyek, mint ebben az esetben különösen, láthatatlanok maradnának. Itt egy olyan tevékenység jelenik meg ezeken a képeken, amelyeknek a lényege az, hogy ez a tevékenység láthatatlan. És ezt a láthatatlan tevékenységet igyekeztek ezek a művészek különböző módon, különböző közegekben láthatóvá tenni. Ezt a célt szolgálja a kiállítás, és azt is, hogy elgondolkodjunk azon a problémán, ahogyan a megfigyelés a mindennapi életünk normális részévé vált olyan annyira, hogy észesen vesszük, hogy egy ilyen világban kell éljük napjainkat. Köszönöm.
Jó estét! Erdély Mátyás vagyok, operatőr.
Mátyás Erdély, the operator, cinematographer.
És amikor István megkért, hogy belerángatott ebbe a helyzetbe, akkor arra jutottam, hogy nem tenném ki magam annak a kellemetlenségnek, hogy itt mélyreható és filozofikus gondolatokkal fárasszam önöket, hanem arra jutottam, hogy egy ilyen könnyed gondolatkísérletbe fogjak.
When István Rév, the director, drew me into this adventure, I thought that I wouldn't bore you with some deep philosophical thoughts, but I would give some light perspective on the question.
És amivel megpróbálkoztam az, hogy a mögöttem látható urak tulajdonképpen kollégáim, és hogy miért van ez így.
What I would like to start with, that these gentlemen behind me are my colleagues, and why they are standing like that.
És hogy tényleg nem egy túl bonyolult, amiben én gondolkozom, de arra jutottam, hogy ugyanazt csináljuk, mindannyian kamerákon keresztül embereket nézünk.
My thought is not very complex on this question, but I thought that we do the same thing. We watch people via cameras.
Mindannyiunknak célja van ezzel. Az ő céljuk az, hogy egy előfeltételezést bizonyítsanak, és ehhez találják meg a szükséges képeket.
We all have our own goals. Their goal is to prove something and to find the relevant pictures for them.
Nekem pedig az a feladatom, hogy a rendező akaratát képekbe lefordítva elérjem azt, hogy a jelenet azt jelentse, amit a forgatókönyvben megfogalmazott a rendező.
And my goal is to translate what the director wants to have at the end in pictures. And I should show what has to be in the script.
Tehát az én dolgom az, hogy generáljak olyan képeket, amik azt jelentik, amit a rendező szeretne, hogy jelentsenek a képek. Ezeknek az ügynököknek pedig az a feladatuk, hogy olyan képeket találjanak, amik alátámasztják azt a feltevést, ami miatt ezeket az embereket ők nézik.
My goal is to generate, to produce pictures that the director would like to see in the film. And these agents have their goal to prove something that exists in reality.
Mindannyian, tehát kamerákon keresztül embereket nézünk, célunk hasonló, mindannyian a főnökeinket szolgáljuk. Az én főnököm a rendező, az ő főnök pedig a tartótiszt, vagy a valami hasonló.
We all serve our bosses. My boss is the director, and their boss is, well, some kind of officer.
Tehát végül is nagyon hasonló, hogy csinálunk, teljesen ellentétes irányból közelítjük meg ugyanazt.
It's similar what we do, but still we approach this from different perspectives.
Én generálok képeket állítok elő, hangulatokat teremtek, amik azt a célt szolgálják, amit a rendező szeretne, hogy szolgáljon. Ők pedig meg kell hogy találják azokat a képeket, amik már ezeket az ő feltevésüket jelentik.
I produce pictures and sentiments, and these people have to find something that exists, and they have to prove certain facts.
Végül is arra jutottam, hogy akkor kerülnék valószínűleg komolyabb problémába, hogyha egy olyan filmet kéne fényképezzek, ami arról szól, hogy egy ügynök megfigyel valakit, és ehhez keres képeket.
I thought that the problem for me would be if I had to make up a movie, a film in which an agent looks for something, has to prove something, and is looking for pictures helping him in this work.
Mert akkor nyilvánvalóan ez a saját farkába rakott kígyó, ez nem eresztene.
It would be a perplexive issue for me then.
És erre jutottam, itt el sem tettem, úgyhogy köszönöm szépen.
Thank you for your attention.